songs I told you last video, in Joji's video with Nayeon, that we are doing a catch-up. We're playing a catch-up here with a bunch of songs that was dropped within this last 2 weeks. And this time we are here to react to Black Eyed Peas, Shakira, David Guetta, Don't You Worry, because this collaboration is incredible, actually. Like, I'm surprised, first of all, that all of these people came together and like, that could be really cool if we make an anthem together. It feels like they came together and said, would Bob would like that? Because like, he listens to us a lot, right? Let's just make him a fan service. Like, let's just give him a fan service. Like, because Shakira, still one of the most beloved ladies of mine. Since my childhood, I know who Shakira is. I always liked how she looks like when it comes to physical appeal, right? But also great music, great dancer, you know, great performer, and also she genuinely is a really good person, you know, from what I can see from the interviews and stuff. Always, I never had a bad taste in my mouth. Never something like suspicious or sketchy. Like, she's a great woman, genuinely. And I was so happy for Gerard Piqué, Barcelona player, and because I'm a Barcelona fan, you know, I was genuinely happy for him. Wow, like, my man is getting the Shakira, you know. And generally, he lived with her like for what, 10 years now. And to see the undeniable, unfortunate fall with, you know, them splitting up, and it seems like Piqué is more at fault here because he has cheated on Shakira. It's just, like, people are only dreaming to freaking to have a wife like Shakira, and you, on the other hand, like, chasing other girls. Like, what's better than Shakira? Like, who's better than Shakira? Like, honestly, like, give me a response right now. Like, honestly, like, she's one of the top women. Like, she's awesome. Like, awesome. And again, like I said, if she had good looks and bad personality, I could be like, at least there's something to it. And even then, you know, nobody can justify cheating. I don't know, like, say, hey, like, it seems like it's not gonna work out anymore. Like, I'm for some reason, I'm chasing other green girls at this point. You know, like, don't cheat, like, release your relationship or something at first, and then, like, break up or something, and then go, like, why lie? And, like, you cheat, and then you don't say that to the other person, you hide that fact for however long before you get exposed, inevitably. It's just a shit show. Anyway, forgot about Piqué. Shakira, we talked about her. Great woman. Black Eyed Peas, another band that I used to adore and listen to their music non-stop when I was a kid. Black Eyed Peas in 2000s was top tier, really, really great music act, very futuristic, very fun, popular, and like, all four of them had great chemistry together. Undeniable bop hits, like, they wrote a lot of good things. And we have David Guetta, right, as well, great rise to stardom in 2000s, sort of still continued to have his dominance in dance charts till I would say 2015-2016. He still appears on the charts and stuff. I think David Guetta is the most relevant still out of the three acts. But even if all three are not like at the peak right now, right, their peak was a bit earlier in their careers of popularity and mainstream appeal, still, I think they can create a bop together because nobody said that they're bad at what they're doing. With that being said, I think we can expect some good stuff happening in this track too. So, Shakira, there you get it. Black Eyed Peas. First reaction? Let's go. Okay, Director X is doing this video. It's gonna be all alright. Thumbs up, ready for the night. Lit like a light, about to take a flight. Yeah, in the YouTube comments they said 2010s vibes, and I cannot agree more. I feel so alive, and I live my best life. That was her reaction to PK's cheating. Like when she found out, whoa, like her eyes went blue. It's like, I'm gonna fucking kill you now. Don't you worry.
Video for Don't You Worry, directed by Director X. So this whole thing is like a global event.
Okay, that's good. That's good. I mean, Black Eyed Peas returned to their form of 2000s, yeah, 2000s era, like with Fergie, right? Now, instead of Fergie, though, we got Shakira on the mix when it comes to vocals. The thing is, I think they are getting a lot of things correct when it comes to sort of appealing to our nostalgia, you know, with the more technological music video, where it's like futuristic music video. The appropriate lights, you know, the color schemes, CGI stuff is all happening, which was very predominant in Black Eyed Peas music videos back in later 2000s. And again, in the music video, we also have Shakira, of course, doing choreography, Black Eyed Peas doing their own choreography. The choreography style was also reminiscent of those back when, you know, they were on top of global charts. But the thing is, something is missing. Even if chorus is really good, it's catchy, don't you worry. It's very catchy. I like the vocals more, like what Black Eyed Peas is doing, Shakira is doing vocally. I like it more, but I wish those vocals landed on a different beat, because what they created with David Guetta and Black Eyed Peas, I mean, it's not I Got a Feeling, unfortunately. It's not such a hyper great track that it's like all flames like I Got a Feeling. It's this one feels a bit less energetic and more stale. The beat is this beat sounds very generic. It sounds like something from 90s. I don't know what it is about it, but it doesn't feel special at all. It's something that I feel like I've heard a lot in like older disco tracks, and that's a letdown, to be honest, because I mean, David Guetta had pretty much one thing to do, and that's making sure that he comes up with a very energetic, fire, interesting beat, and he usually succeeds in that mission, or even exceeds my expectations. But this one, it was a bit boring to me, at least. And again, the strategy behind the song was good. They had to play on nostalgia. Oh, it's like Black Eyed Peas, Shakira, you know, all in one track. It's a big deal, and they made it seem also like a big deal. You know, it's an anthem. It's like global event. Like Black Eyed Peas, Will I Am mentioned on the video. The intent was right, and the idea was right, but I think the execution just lacked in one department. It just lacked the beat itself, the sound itself. Unfortunately, not that great. Even if you have great packaging, inside, what you get is not that deep, is not that great, unfortunately. And that's why other things, no matter how great they were, it's kind of falls apart a little bit. And I'm really sad to say that because, you know me, like, I love this artist. It hurts to say that. I want to like it, you know what I mean? And I will try to like it. Actually, I'll be listening to it not one time still. And to see maybe my opinion, if it will change. As a first listen, this is how I feel. And I cannot lie, you know, I gotta be honest with you guys. So this is how I feel. This is what I'm expressing. Next, we have Gorillaz. The song's name is Cracker Island with Thundercat, which is really interesting choice for collaboration. And over the years, I just noticed how many collaborations Gorillaz have under their belt. Damon Albarn, you know, how many great, great musicians he worked with. Like, even, let's just take the album Humans, Pusha T and Gorillaz, you know, like, first thoughts, like, what? But it works, like, that song is great, Let Me Out. And there's more songs. Just like Song Machine from 2020, right? In that album, how many great collaborations we had. Slow Tie, we had freaking Elton John. Like, there's so many artists, cool artists that Gorillaz work with. And with music videos, if you go back to Stylo, in the music videos you had freaking Bruce Willis appearing on the music video, which was so cool and really well made. And just not too long ago, in 2018, you had Jack Black on the music video for I forgot the song, Humility. All I'm saying is it's very impressive that Gorillaz is still a thing and they still keep going. It's been more than 20 years now and they keep surprising us with great collaborations, great songs, and the legend of Gorillaz still going, still happening. Thank you, Gorillaz, for the great memories. And let's get another one now. Cracker Island, first reaction, let's go. On Cracker Island, it was born. What? To the collective of the dawn, where the truth was so untrue. Ethical, and it's sad and so consumed. Ethical, in the end, I had to pay. What is this? In the end, I had to pay. Hurt my soul, right? They told themselves to be a clown. They didn't know his many strategies. To be a clown. They didn't know his many strategies. I'm Cracker Island, it was right. It only came out at night. It ate up my paradise. Where the truth was all untrue. Caught in between the times. Shocked myself. I had a lot of my surprise. Gorillaz, yeah, they went crazy on this one. And Thundercat, oh my god, that guitar finger pick, that was crazy. Like, the definitely Thundercat was wilding on that production. It was awesome. Yeah, the guitar riffs were, again, like, crazy. Wow, insane. It's just like, from the start, like, the way it starts, I was not expecting, like immediately you just go in, like, you're in the song. It's like, first it's like, wait, what's happening again? Like, where are you taking me? But, yeah, it was very nice song. Top tier, Gorillaz, that was cool. And let's see what they have for us next. But for now, though, we're gonna enjoy this one until they give us some more. So nothing else to say for Gorillaz. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hit the like button if you like this video, subscribe to this channel. And again, more is coming, so stay tuned. We have Kaigo still waiting for my reaction. Kaigo community, where you at? Comment below. And Gorillaz community also. Let me know how you feel about this song. Do you like it or not? Yeah, also let me know in the comments below your opinion on Don't You Worry. Maybe even tell me a story, just like I told you about my love for Black Eyed Peas, Shakira and David Guetta. Maybe some memories in the nightclub or something, dancing to their songs when you were younger or something. Like, just give me something in the comments below. Let me read your stories. And on that note, I'll see you guys in the next ones. Bye.